high above. A broken heart, you can feel with.
Good morning, good morning, family. Good morning and welcome. Good morning. God bless you all. We love you. We appreciate you. We value each and every one of you. Thank you so much for coming on this morning. Amen. Thank you for standing with us. Thank you for those that are fasting. We appreciate you. Amen. We thank you for being a part of this awesome family. Amen. Blessings, blessings from Virginia, Chicago. Thank you all so much for inviting your followers and for sharing. You guys are so awesome. We don't even have to ask. We thank you so much. Yes. Because you want everybody else to receive what you're receiving. Amen. Yes, yes. We appreciate you. We had an awesome time. Even last night in Discipleship Training Institute. Powerful training. Amen. Moses, Nelson, Maria, God bless you all. Sharp Burns 5, God bless you. Yes, blessings, blessings. Dominique Steele, blessings. Bookery, God bless you. Yes, Sabrina Good, thank you for inviting your followers. Thank you so much. Gwen Vincent, D. Williams, we appreciate you so much. Chosen Generation. Yes, Jay, God bless you. You have to let me know what the J stands for. Generation Jesus, right? Okay. Yes. Hallelujah. The name of this song is This Altar, and it's on the Psalmist Rain Worship CD. This Altar. Yes. Omar, blessings and welcome to you. Karen, we love you. Yes. Indiana. Oh, Generation Joshua. Okay. Yes. Awesome. Well, welcome. We're certainly grateful to have you. LA Halos, blessings to you. Yes. Yes, we started the fast in preparation for our Indiana Suddenly. That's taking place on May the 12th and 13th. And so we were 21 days out, and we started that fast for 21 days. And you can certainly join us in this time of fasting. Amen. And we're going until from midnight until tomorrow evening is our time. We're doing a total fast. And so whatever you position in your heart to do, whether it's a Daniel's fast or a partial fast, blessings to you. Yes. Good morning. Blessings. God bless you. I am Felicia H. Good morning, Jaden. We missed you. Hope you had an awesome time in Tallahassee. Nanette, we thank God for you. Thank you so much for continuing to support LaJun and Valora Cole Ministries. For all of you, we appreciate that. Yes. Hallelujah. My God, yes. We're getting ready. We're getting ready. We're positioning ourselves. We're preparing. Amen. We're posturing ourselves for what God has for us. Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Diana Harrison, God bless you and thank you so much. Thank you. Yes. Jesus, Jesus forever. Thank you so much. I love that handle. Love 16. Thank you for inviting your followers. Good morning, California. Yes. Roxy, you're awesome. Thank you for inviting. Thank you. Hi, Craig. God bless you, Yvette. God bless you, Alicia Benford Griffin, great woman of God in Houston. Yes. Chandra Bird, we welcome you. Blessings, Texas. Yes. Texas over here. Amen. Texas is well represented. Amen. Well, we're going to pray continued strength that you're going to finish that paper. God is going to give you an overwhelming grace to finish that 20-page paper. She says she stopped writing her 20-page paper to listen. Amen. Amen. We're going to release the anointing, the pen of a ready writer. Amen. Yes. Oh, some more working on their research papers. Amen. Thank you so much for coming on. Thank you for sharing. I know many of you were on the scope this afternoon. It was so powerful. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Blessings. This beautiful grandmother had asked for prayer for her granddaughter that was contemplating suicide, said she didn't want to live anymore, and so she has a great testimony that God intervened, and thank you all so much for praying for her. Thank you. She really appreciates you guys, all of us.
Hallelujah. I was reading two scriptures in particular tonight, and I want to read John chapter 5, and I want to read Acts chapter 3, and then we're going to pray. Because the title of the scope was, as I was meditating and praying about this, the title of the scope is, you get ready to have the probably the greatest and the biggest suddenly you've ever had in your entire life. And so I want to pray for people who need God to really, really minister to them supernaturally. This is not just one of those scenarios where, you know, I was talking about this in class tonight, and I asked the question, there's two people, and don't get me wrong, God is going to answer both prayers, but there are people whose situation is a little bit more dire than other ones. And so I want to pray for those people who are in situations where you really, really need God to break through for you. Amen. Where God really, really, if God doesn't do it for you, it's going to be tough. Amen. Hallelujah. So I want to pray for those people tonight. I want to read these two scriptures. The first one is John chapter 5, verse number, John chapter 5, verse 5 through 9. It said, a certain man was there which had an infirmity 38 years, and when Jesus saw him lying, knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he said unto him, wilt thou be made whole? And the impotent man answered him and said, sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another man steppeth down before me. Jesus said unto him, rise, take up thy bed and walk. And immediately the man was made whole and took up his bed and walked, and on the same day was the Sabbath. And the next scripture I want to read is Acts chapter 3, verse 2 through 8. And if you have the Suddenly book, I'm reading from page 96 and 97. Again, if those of you who just joined on, I'm reading from the Suddenly book, amen, page 96 and 97, and reading those two scriptures, Acts chapter 3, verse 2 through 8. And it says, a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple, who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, look on us. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. And then Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up. And immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he, leaping upon them, stood and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. So tonight I want to pray and I want to believe God for supernatural miracles to be manifest in your hands. Amen. I want to see God do something amazing. I want to see God do something supernatural in your life, not just something regular. I want this to be one of the most amazing miracles that God has ever done in your life. Yes. And so that's what we're going to pray for tonight. We're going to pray by faith, believing God for supernatural something, supernatural manifestations of his presence, supernatural manifestations, supernatural, supernatural reconciliation, supernatural manifestation, supernatural release, supernatural power, supernatural strength. Even as this man of God who had been lame for many years, and he all of a sudden saw God begin to just move in his situation.
Yes.
Even others, amen, who began to see God do something supernatural in their life. This man had been in his situation 38 years. Mm-hmm. And so when God asked him, "Do you want me to make you whole?" He didn't even have an understanding of how to answer the question. The only thing he had seen was that when the water was troubled, that the angel came down at a certain time and troubled the water. And so he understood that the angel had the capacity to heal him, but he did not have the understanding that Jesus had the ability to heal him.
Yes.
And so we want to pray tonight for God to begin to move for you. If you need deliverance, if you need healing, if you need breakthrough, if you need reconciliation, you know, whatever it is that you need tonight, we want to pray and we want to believe God for amazing things to happen in your life so that you begin to see God do something that you have not seen him do before. And so we want to pray. We want to stand in agreement with you. We want to believe God. I don't care what it is. I don't care what your situation is. You know, somebody said, "I've been in my situation for just a few years. I can imagine 38, but I'm telling you, he is the God who is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you can think or ask according to the power that worketh in you. And so tonight we starve our doubt and we feed our faith and we decree that God is the God of the suddenly. He is the God who can do it immediately. He can do it straightway. He is the God who can turn any situation around. There is no situation too hard for him. There is no situation that he cannot fix. There is no situation that's too challenging for him.
Yes.
And so we stand on the authority and the faith that we have in God, and we believe him for supernatural miracles. I don't care how hard your situation is. I don't care how long you've been in your situation. I want you to share this now, because when we pray, I want to believe God for as many people as we can to be healed, to be set free, to be delivered. And so I want you to share. I want everybody who just came on, if you just came on, I want you to share it. I want you to share it. I want you to share it. I want you to let other people know that we're on.
Hallelujah.
Because we're going to put our faith together, and we're going to put our faith together to see healing, to see supernatural miracles, to see the manifestation of God do something amazing in the lives of his people. Amen. So we want to believe God together. We want to stand together. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for all of those who are believing God for something supernatural. And thank you for all those who are believing God to do something supernatural for your brothers and sisters who are on these scopes.
Yes.
Because there are some people on the scope, and yes, you have a situation that you need God to do something, but there are also other people on the scope who need God to do something amazing. They need God to do something for them, and they are in a dire situation. Mm-hmm. Somebody asked me tonight, because when we travel to other nations, is it possible that people in other nations, in places where they don't have doctors, where they don't have all the resources that we have in America, they ask me, do they have greater capacity to receive miracles? Do they believe God for things that we do not believe him for in our nations? Amen. I'm not sure about the time that these two men were healed, but I'm not sure that they had medical insurance. I'm not sure that they had jobs. I'm not sure that they had the ability to reach out to God for God to do it another way. There was no other alternative.
Right.
They had no plan B. The only thing they had was God being able to be God in their lives and do something supernatural.
Yes.
And so they had been in their pain. They had been in their challenge. They had been in their storm so long.
Jesus.
And they said, "My God, I need God to do something for me that I cannot do for myself." So I need you guys who've been on these prayer scopes and believing God for doing miracles. I need you to stand with us in faith to believe God to do something supernatural on behalf of these people. Amen.
Yes.
Many of you have been with us. Your faith is built up. Will you stand with us, and will you decree and will you declare with us that God is able to turn around even the most challenging of situations, that he's even able to heal the most broken of hearts, that he's able to restore the most broken of relationships, that he's able to restore that person who's been sick and in their infirmity for 38 years, that relationship which has been broken for 38 years. I want you to pray tonight, and I want you to pray tonight like it was you in the situation. That God can turn it around, no matter what it looks like, no matter how it feels. Will you stand with us tonight to see God move like he has not moved before in their lives? Will you see this be the most wonderful and most magnificent and most grandiose and most amazing mega suddenly that they have ever experienced? Will you stand with us tonight in prayer? So, Father, we thank you tonight.
Yes.
And we thank you for your grace and your mercy and your strength. Oh, God, we pray now, God, that in the name of Jesus, God, that even every assignment of hell that's been framed against us and that's come against us, Father, we pray against against it tonight. And we stand in authority. And God, we stand, oh Heavenly Father, in agreement, God, with your word, oh Heavenly Father. God, we decree tonight that, God, people are healed. We decree tonight that people are set free, that they're let loose, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, we bind, oh God, every demonic assignment against the lives of your sons and your daughters, Jesus. Even against ministries, even against churches, oh God, even as we begin to maintain momentum and we begin to start to see momentum and increase, Father, we bind the demons and the devils, God, that have come to stop us. Father, I pray for supernatural healing, God, for your sons and your daughters that are upon this scope, oh God, even for those who will watch it later. God, I pray now, in the name of Jesus, God, that you do supernatural miracles, oh God, even as you did it for Peter, even as you did it for Jesus, even as you did it for John, even as you did it for James, even as you did it for other disciples in the Bible and the stories that we read. Father, I pray that you manifest your miraculous power, oh Heavenly Father, for these your sons and your daughters. God, let this be a time and a season in their life where they experience your suddenly, because you are yet able to do anything but fail. You are yet able to change, to transform. Oh God, you are yet able to reconcile. God, you're yet able to heal. God, there is nothing too hard for you. God, there is no debt that's too big for you. God, there is nothing, no situation, no storm, no circumstance, God, that you cannot turn it around. And so, Father, we stand in agreement with the authority of your word, which declares that when two of us shall come together, God, and touch and agree concerning anything that we ask, God, that you would answer our prayer. So, Father, I pray now that you break them loose, God, break through financially for them, God. Yes, supernatural debt elimination, God, supernatural reconciliation, supernatural healing, even as you did for this man who had been in his situation for 38 years, even as you had for the other man who lay at the gate built beautiful. Father, we pray now, even as some have been asking for alms, but God healed them and God caused them to be those who would give alms, God. God, we even if there are some of us, God, who do not have the silver and gold to give them, but Father, we thank you now, God, that you're releasing God's supernatural anointing by your spirit, God. It's by your spirit, by your power. God, it's not by our strength or by our might, but it's by your spirit that this is going to happen tonight. And so, Father, we thank you, God, that you're breaking everything, yes. God, that opposes our forward momentum. You're breaking every assignment of hell that's been framed against us, and God, every demon and every assignment, God, and everything that's come to cause confusion and distraction, God, mm-hmm. and cause, God, destruction, oh God, and everything that's come to cause, oh God, even depression, oh God, and yes. division, God, in yes. our marriages, in our relationships, yes. and everything else that pertains yes. to us, God. We thank you that you're breaking it now. Father, we thank you that we can trust you, that we can believe in you. Father, you're not a God who can fail. You're not a God, oh God, who has ceased to be amazing in our lives. And so, Father, I break that assignment of hell that's been coming against your sons and your daughters, God. And I declare that now even the backslider is coming back, God. The husband is coming back, God. The wife is coming back, God. The ministry is coming back, oh Heavenly Father. God, the finances are coming back. You're giving them supernatural vision and ideas and understanding and wisdom, God. You're causing everything, God, that's caused them to be held up, God, and everything that's been held up in their lives, we're calling it to come back now, and we're causing it to break now in the name of Jesus, Father. We declare now that you're giving us an anointing, God, that transcends, God, time and space, oh God. You're giving us an anointing, God, that can break through in the hardest of situations, God. We command now, even for the word to go out, God, and not to return back until it has accomplished that which you sent it to do. Yes. Father, we pray now, even as if though it were us in the situation, God, even though it were our family member, God, that's healed, that needs healing, God, that's sick, oh God, we pray now according to the authority of your word that, God, you'll give us breakthrough in yes. Jesus' name. Father, we pray now, God, for supernatural manifestation, God, of reconciliation now in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you now, God, that every situation and every circumstance, God, that your people are praying about, everything that they're going through, everything yes. that they're dealing with, oh God, God, that you're breaking them through. Yes, promotion is their portion, and Father, let yes. your power, let your anointing come upon them now, God, for supernatural breakthrough. God, I release an anointing tonight, God, for supernatural breakthrough yes. in the name of Jesus. Yes, families yes. are healed. Ministries are healed. Situations are healed. Circumstances are healed. Oh, God, finances are healed. God, break it now by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. Father, do not let the enemy prevail, oh, God, over their situation. Do not let the enemy win, oh, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Lives are at stake. Health is at stake, God. Ministries are at stake. Businesses are at stake. So many many things are at stake tonight, God. So many people's faith is at stake. Even as your word said in Luke, oh God, chapter 18, God, let it manifest, oh God, that when you return, God, you would see, oh God, healing on earth. God, let it be that when you look down into the earth, oh God, in the lives of these are your sons and your daughters, Father, manifest the healing so that they would know, oh God, that you are God, and besides you, there is none other, that there is nothing, and that there is no one that can stop you from moving in their situation, that can stop you from healing them, that can stop you from delivering them. There is no drug too strong. There is no sickness and no infirmity, oh God, no spirit of infirmity, God, that's stronger than your blood. Yes. And so, Father, we thank you, oh God, that you're able to do, even as your word declares, exceeding abundantly above all that we can ask or think according to the power, oh God, that's working in us. God. And Father, we declare that that power that's working in us is dunamis power. It is the ability to work miracles. It is the ability to heal. Oh God, it's the ability to set free. It is the ability to deliver. So Father, we thank you tonight, God, that we're breaking every demonic cycle, not over our lives, but even over our cities, oh God. Even as Paul told Timothy to pray, God, for governors and rulers, God, we pray for our cities. We pray for our neighborhoods. We pray for everything that pertains to us, oh God. And we break every demonic cycle. God, we reach up, oh God, into places, God, where the enemy, oh God, has tried to destroy us and tried to kill us, God. And God tried to destroy even our places, oh God, our hopelessness, God. He's tried to destroy our hope. He's tried to destroy our strength. He's tried to drain us. He's tried to bring every assassin that he could send. And so we break his power tonight. Oh God, we realize we don't fight against power and, oh God, against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities and rulers of wickedness in dark places, God. So we thank you, God, that you're breaking us through. You're breaking us loose. You're breaking us out like you've never had before in the name of Jesus. Yes, we break the powers of hell that have been framed against us, against our churches, against our ministries. We break the powers of hell and we declare that now breakthrough is our portion. Father, we declare now that not even one more person, God, will be drawn out, oh God, by the hand of the enemy trying to destroy them. Not one more sheep, God, oh God, would be able to leave by the purpose of offense, God. Oh God, and that sickness, oh God, that this person who has been sick for many years, this person who's been praying for this person who's sick for many years, Father, that they would receive their breakthrough now in the name of Jesus like never before. Father, let your power go forth and let your anointing, God, break everything, God, at every cycle. Oh God, even every cycle. Jesus, God, some have been caught up in the same cycle year after year and season after season, but Father, we break those seasons and we break those cycles, God, and we declare that you're showing us now what we're doing and what we should be doing, God, that's causing these cycles in our lives. We're causing, oh Heavenly Father, even our understanding, God, to go to another level, oh God, our understanding and our vision and our creativity and our understanding of how to break those cycles, God, is coming now. And yes, you're releasing the rain, God, the rain of your spirit, the rain of your anointing, the rain of provision, God. You're causing it to flow now like never before, because once we've broken the cycles and we've destroyed everything that did not look like you, yes, God, you're bringing, oh God, your provision, and you're bringing, oh Heavenly Father, oh God, every provision that we need. Even your rain is coming, God. The dew of your presence is coming in the name of Jesus. Father, we bless you tonight, and we decree, God, that your strength and your power and your healing anointing, God, is falling fresh upon us like never before in Jesus' name. Signs, wonders, and miracles shall come forth, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Signs, wonders, and miracles, God. Your glory shall manifest, God. And we declare that when your, oh God, when your glory manifests, oh Heavenly Father, and when your power manifests and when your strength manifests, oh God, that we will see breakthrough like we have never seen it before in Jesus' name. We pray. Amen.
Glory to the Lamb of God. I just hear the Lord said, I am the God of breakthrough. I am the God that delivers. I am the God that sets free. I am the God that destroys the enemy of your soul. I am the God that causes restoration in your life. I'm causing restoration to take place in your life and in your family. Those things that have been scattered, those things that have been separated, those relationships that have been separated, God said, I'm restoring them. I'm bringing them back together. I'm fortifying them. I'm strengthening them even now. Oh, glory. God said, you're rising up. You're rising up out of that place of affliction. You're rising up. And I just see people rising up out of hospital beds. God said, you're rising up. Those that have been given up to die, those that have serious infirmities that have attacked their body, but I see them rising up. Now God is the God that heals thee. He said, I am the God that heal you. I am the God that delivers you. I've come to set you free. I've come to deliver. I've come to perform miracles in your life, things that cannot be explained, that science cannot explain, that the judge cannot explain. I am the God that specializes in the impossible. When man said it's impossible, know that it is possible with me. I am your Father. I am the lover of your soul. I am the one that created you, and I'm creating new things in your life. I'm giving you new body parts. I'm giving you new organs. I'm giving you new visions. I'm giving you new strategies. I'm giving you new things. Receive the new. Expect God to do new things. And God said, I'm giving you new things. New things shall you behold. You will begin to see things that you've never seen before. You will begin to hear things you've never heard before. You will begin to receive things that you've never received before. What you thought was impossible, what you thought and you said to yourself that it will never happen for me. I know it happened for somebody else, but I don't qualify. I don't have the background that they have. I don't have the support that they have. But God said, I'm going to supersede that. I'm going to supersede every qualification, because I am God, and besides me, there is no other. Continue to trust in me, lean on me, trust in me with all of your heart, and lean not to your own understanding, but in all of your ways, acknowledge the Lord God. And God said, I will direct your path. I will lead you and guide you. I will take you into places that you've never been. I will take you and do things in your life and through your life that you haven't even imagined yet, because I am the true and the living God. I am your Lord and I am your master. And so even now, in the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you. We thank you for these, your sons and your daughters. We thank you that you've heard the cry of the righteous, that you've heard them and that you've seen them. You've seen the affliction. You've seen, God, how the enemy has come against them. You have seen how they have warred and how they have battled and how they have fought and how they have cried and how they have persevered. You've seen the seeds that they have sown. You've seen them, Father God, as they have sacrificed their life, as they have sacrificed their time, as they've had to overcome many trials and hard tribulations. So God, even now, I thank you that you're raising them up. You're lifting them up even above their enemies. God, I thank you right now that you're performing your word. As you have sent your word to them, God, you have healed them. You've healed them in every area of their life. So even now, arise. God says, arise. It's time for you to arise. It's time for you to take up your bed. It's time for you to go forth. It's time for you to overcome the very thing that has kept you down. God said, it's time for you to walk on the things that have kept you at a place where it seems like you couldn't go forward and you seem like to always regress. But God said, this is the season of progression. This is the season where you've got to accelerate, that he's accelerating you. And so God said, don't take your time. Don't look back. Don't wait. God said, this is not the season to wait. This is not the season to say, if, oh God, I'll do it. If maybe it'll happen. If God says, no, you've got to move. When you hear my voice, you've got to move, because I'm moving quickly. I'm moving suddenly. I'm moving by without notice. Hallelujah. So you've got to be ready. You got to have your bags packed. Some of you, God is saying, you got to get your bags packed. And I even know God has been speaking to some of you to pack your bags. And you say, God, I don't know. I don't know what that means. I don't know. God, is that really you? God say, yes, it is me. It's time to pack your bag. Go ahead and begin to pack, because God is going to give you instruction. There are some places that God is about to take you that is going to blow your literal mind. Hallelujah. There are some doors that God is going to open for you that you only could even imagine, that you only read about in past times. But God said, you're going to walk in those places. You're going to meet those people. God said, he is positioning you even now for this season. He's positioning you for greater things. God said, greater. He said, because when he sees you, he sees the greater. And so sometimes we look at what we see right now, but God sees the greater. So you got to look through the eyes of God. You got to look through it and understand what God is doing and how he's moving by his power and by his spirit. So even now, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, you serve a God. You serve a God that specializes in the impossible. Every day, miracles are a normal to him. Miracles is something that he does on a daily basis. Every minute of the day, there are miracles that are being released by the hand of God. Hallelujah. And so even now, I'm sending forth miracles, saith the Lord. I'm sending forth miracles from the north, the south, the east, and the west. I'm sending forth miracles in Houston, Texas. I'm sending forth miracles in the United Kingdom. I'm sending forth miracles in the Philippines. I'm sending forth miracles in Atlanta, in Indianapolis. I'm sending forth miracles. Come on and receive it now. Come on and catch the miracle, because every single minute of the day, miracles are being performed by the hand of God. They are being released. Supernatural breakthrough is coming forth in the name of Jesus. Don't let your miracle pass you by. Don't let your suddenly pass you by. Grab hold of it now in Jesus' name and say, God, I thank you. I receive it. I take hold of it right now. I thank you, God, that it's done. I thank you, God, that it's manifesting. Healing
has already manifested in your body in the name of Jesus. So even now, as I begin to see people in the hospital bed, I begin to see them on dialysis and they're getting up. Glory to God. This is the season to arise. This is the season to go forth. This is the season to conquer all. This is the season to testify of the goodness of God and everything that he said in his word, everything that is being performed in your life. It is the time to testify in the name of Jesus. Don't waste your trial. Don't waste what you're dealing with and going through right now, because there is coming a greater reward. This is only a light thing. It's a light affliction, but it's working for you a far more greater weight of glory in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes, yes. God is the one. He is the one, the true and the living God. He's Elohim. Come on. He's Adonai. He's Lord and Master over your life. He is El Shaddai. He's the God of more than enough. My God, you're going to walk in a place of such miracles. You're going to receive miracles, but then God is going to allow you to perform miracles. Hallelujah. Miracles are going to come to you, but they're also going to be released through you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Yes, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Yes, yes. Arise, arise, arise. Come on, arise out of that place. Arise. It's time to get up. It's time to move. It's time to get up. Hallelujah. As I said, God is saying that some of you, he's told to pack. You don't know where you're going. Come on, Abraham. Abraham didn't have all the detail. God just said, go. My God, some of you are going to just have to go, because your blessing is in the going. Your blessing may not be where you are, what's familiar to you. It may not be around your family. And God said, it's time to go, because what I have for you, it's not where you are, but it's where you're going in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, somebody said, I'm already packed. Amen. Amen. This is a time. This is a season. It is strategic. Glory to the Lamb of God. And God is moving every single minute of the day. God is releasing something in the lives of his people.
You got to receive that. Let me tell you something. As we've been talking about, God is doing some amazing things in the lives of his people. And I really felt an anointing for this tonight. I felt an anointing, you know, and of course, Jesus. We always feel an anointing to pray. But sometimes Jesus. God is giving what's the word I'm looking for? God is giving instruction. And so when we pray, we're also asking God for instruction. Even as I was sitting here tonight, this Wednesday night, we're not just going to have a regular Bible study. We're going to have prayer. Amen. We're going to have intercession. Our whole Wednesday night is going to be prayer, intercession, and worship. Amen. Because I really believe that we're in a season where we really need to have, we really need to get instruction. We really need to hear from God. We need to all be on one accord.
Yes.
I called somebody today and they were saying, they said, well, one of the things that I want you to do in this season is I want you guys to really focus more on intercession and prayer than anything else. And this is one of the people that advised me and pray, because there's some areas that we're expecting breakthrough.
Yes.
So we do not, you know, in this season, you can't just act like everything is normal and everything is usual when you're in a place where you need God to break through. Amen.
Yes.
And so what you have to do is you have to be able to, at this place, get into a place where you're praying more, in a place where you're fasting more, in a place where you're really believing God for breakthrough, and in areas where your life is not aligning with the word of God, you got to bring it into alignment. If you're in a place, amen, where you know you need to starve some doubt because you're not believing that God can do it, then guess what you got to do? You got to do what? You got to now starve your doubt, feed your faith, believe God for supernatural miracles, because I believe that this is the season that God wants to do it. We just got to cause our faith to arise to the place that we can receive what God is saying.
Yes.
Amen. And so we're going to pray. We're going to intercede. And I'm going to find a way for those of you who are connected to us. Maybe we'll stream it. I need to find out how we're going to do it on Wednesday night.
Yes.
But I know many of you will connect with us. And we're going to be praying. We're going to be believing God. We're still going to be here tomorrow at 1. We're still going to be here tomorrow at midnight. But I just believe that when we do a corporate environment of prayer, that there is something that happens. When the 120 were in the upper room, amen, and they begin to fight and they begin to pray together, I really believe that that God does something amazing, amen,
yes.
When we come together.
Yes.
And so when people come together and believe God, when people come together and believe God for supernatural miracles, he does just what we're asking for. It's impossible for God to lie. It's impossible for God to change. change. It's impossible for him not to do what we're asking him to do. Amen. And so when we stand in agreement, amen, with the power of faith and believe God for supernatural miracles, mm-hmm. we see God do amazing things. Are you listening to me? So yes. Some of you are in a place where you are believing God and you're praying for God to do something amazing and something supernatural. And so we're going to believe God with you, and we're going to stand in agreement yes. that God is going to do something that he has not done before. It's going to be yes. a time of supernatural breakthrough. Amen. We're going to starve our doubt, and we're going to feed our faith until we see the manifestation of the things that we've been praying for. Amen. Things that we've been praying for, things that we've been praying for, things that we've been praying for, things that we've been believing God for, things we've been trusting God for. Mm-hmm. And some of you have not seen the manifestation of it. We're going to be standing in agreement and praying for you and believing yes. God for breakthrough. Amen. And so I'm excited. I get excited when these times come, because mm-hmm. sometimes the more the challenges comes, the more the storms come, it's the greater time for us to pray and believe God for something even greater than we've believed him for in the beginning. Amen. And yes. so even when we started this whole season of fasting and praying and believing God for suddenly, amen, I believe that even more now we need to receive and we need to believe God for supernatural things and amazing things to begin to happen more now than we did in the beginning. Amen.
Yes.
So thank you for those that have shared. If you just came on and you have not had opportunity to share, I would love for you to share one more time, because I want people to get this. I want people, amen, to receive the anointing and the impartation of prayer and of fasting and of being able to believe God for amazing things. Thank you for those that are sharing. Thank you for those that are releasing it, because I'm telling you, I believe that in our corporate anointing that God is able to do exceeding, even as the scriptures say, abundantly above all we could think or ask. And so you've been asking for one thing, God's going to exceed that. You've been believing for one thing, God's going to exceed that. You've been yes. praying for one thing, God's going to exceed that, because we serve a powerful God who is able to do anything but fail. As I told you, sometimes we go to other countries, and sometimes in other countries, mm-hmm. their faith level is at a place that all they got is God. All they have is God. And so when they call and when they come to the meetings, they're expecting yes. God to do it. And we see supernatural miracles wrought in those countries. But I want to see revival in America.
Yes.
I want to see powerful manifestations of the presence of God in America. Jesus. I don't want to just have to get on a flight and travel 6, 12, 14, 16, 20 hours to see the manifestation of the power of God. I want to see the manifestation of the power of God in our own churches, in our own neighborhoods, in our own communities, because I want to see America change. It used to be yes. that people from America were going to other countries to see change happen. Now we're seeing other people come to America to see change happen. But yes. I believe that change is going to come to your city. Change is going to come to your family. Change is yes. going to come to your life. I believe that this is the season that God is going to do amazing things, and he's going to anoint you to do it. Amen. He didn't just anoint those in the biblical days. He's anointing you
yes.
and he's called you to do amazing things, and he's called you to heal the sick, and he's called you to lay hands, amen, and cast out demonic presences and things that cause disease, and he has called you to do great things. And so I believe that God is calling you to do great things
yes.
and that you are going to do great things. If you're watching this
yes.
scope, or if you're watching the scope later on, I'm telling you, if you're watching this on YouTube, if you're watching us later on YouTube, I'm telling you that I believe that God is going to use you to do amazing things. I believe that God is going to use you to do amazing things.
Yes.
You're watching this by Periscope. You're watching this by Facebook Live. You're watching this by YouTube. God is going to use you. You might as well say it.
Yes.
God is going to use me, amen, to do supernatural miracles.
Yes.
Because there is somebody whose faith is not at the place that your faith is, and God wants to use you to lay hands on them and see them heal. He wants to use you. That's why God gave me those two different scriptures, because one was Jesus doing it, but the next one was his disciples doing it. Amen.
Yes.
And so God wants to use those who've been called into you don't have to have a title. You don't have to have the title of apostle or prophet or evangelist or pastor or teacher. All you got to do is have the title of willing. All you got to have the title is of obedient.
Yes.
And God said, I'm going to
yes.
use you. My Before hand
yes.
is going to be upon you. I'm looking for your yes. I'm looking for your anointing. And if you will say yes, I'll use you. If you'll go out and not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, if you'll go out and lay hands on the sick, they're going to recover. If you'll go out and prophesy to them, they're going to be healed. If you'll go out and speak
yes.
to the mountain, it's going to move. If you go out and speak and pray for the person who needs reconciliation, it's going to happen. Don't you dare let relationships break on your watch. You ought to say, not on my watch. Amen. Yes. You ought to say, my God, it's not happening on my watch. Amen. Yes. Sickness is not going to reign on my watch. Yes. Relationships are not going to be broken on my watch. Marriages are not going to fail on my watch. Amen. People are not going to backslide on my watch. Not on my watch. On my watch, we're going to pray and we're going to decree and we're going to declare and we're going to be like the apostles and the prophets of the early days, that when they prayed and they believed God for something, they saw the manifestation of the things that they were praying for. Yes. So that's our thing. It's not going to happen on our watch. Amen. We're not going to deal with poverty. We're not going to be broke. We're not going to see brokenness. We're not going to see division. Not on my watch. I'm not letting it happen. This is why we have midnight cry, because we want to believe God to do something, and we're not going to let it happen on our watch. We're not going to let you stay sick on our watch. We're not going to let you stay broke on our watch. We're not going to let people be homeless on our watch. We're not letting people do it. It's not going to happen on our watch. We're not letting see churches divided on our watch. We're not letting ministries go down and stop on our watch. Too many have gone. We're not letting people commit suicide on our watch. Amen. We got too much faith. There's too many of us, and there's too much anointing, and there's too much power on this scope. There's too much power in your life. There's too much power in the word of God for us to receive and let the enemy destroy things that have been coming against us, and even the accusations and the trials and the storms and the issues and the things that the enemy is trying to destroy you, depress you, divide you, cause you even to be distracted. We're not letting it happen on our watch. Amen. No more distraction. Amen. No more division. Amen. No more discouragement. No more depression. Yes. No more. Not on our watch. Amen. Yes. We're praying for God to restore, for God to heal, Lord, for God to deliver, to God to set free, for God to change even the hardest of minds, the minds that have been saying, I'm not going to go back. I'm not going to get back into place. I'm gone. I'm walking out of this. I'm leaving this alone. That husband who is stubborn and stiff-necked, that wife who is stubborn and stiff-necked, that member, that son, that daughter who is stiff-necked, and that father or that mother who is stiff-necked, not on my watch.
Yes. Jesus. Glory to God.
Not on my
Glory
watch.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
Mm-mm, we're not
Glory
accepting that.
God.
Not on my watch.
Glory to God.
Not on my watch, devil. Not on my watch.
Yes.
You are not destroying this thing on my watch.
Yes.
We're not releasing it like that.
Jesus.
We're going to stand and we're going to believe for God to do
amazing things
in the lives of his people.
Yes. Glory to God.
Not on my watch.
Glory to your name.
You better be a watchman on the wall.
My God, yes.
You've been assigned to Shamar, the church of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
And so you say, not on my watch.
Yes, God.
I'm not going to fall asleep. I'm not going to be slumbering. I'm not going to be slothful. Not on my watch.
Jesus. Yes.
I'm not doing it. Amen. I'm not letting it happen on my watch.
Come on. Yes.
I'm not letting it happen. Jesus. I'm not letting the enemy do it on my watch.
Yes.
I am assigned to pray. I am assigned to decree. I am assigned to declare. And I will not stop decreeing and declaring until I see the manifest. I won't get tired.
Yes.
I won't get frustrated. I will not let the enemy come in and destroy what God has been building on my watch.
Yes.
And I realize it's not people, but it is the presence of the enemy that's working behind them.
Yes.
Not on my watch.
Jesus. Jesus. Glory to God. Glory
Speak those God. Things that be not as though they were. I like that.
Yes, absolutely.
Even though it looks bad, decree, no, not on my watch.
Yes.
You do not have the authority.
Yes.
I have the authority.
Yes.
You have to speak to that situation.
My God, my God.
If it's going on in your house, if it's going on in your church, if it's going on in your finances, if it's going on in your marriage, you have to decree, not on my watch. I bind the devil and the assignment of hell that's been coming against me, and I declare that I will not faint, but I'm going to see the manifestation of the promises of God. I will not die. I will live, and I will declare the word of God, because I have the authority. I have the power. You have all these precious promises in this book, these scriptures. Amen. You got to get into it. You got to read it. You got to declare it. You got to decree it.
Yes.
Yes. You got to get in it. You got to find your promise in here and pray it and prophesy it and pray it and prophesy it and decree it and declare it. And you got to look and you got to find until God gives you the answer. If it's your finances, if it's your marriage, if it's your church, if it's your ministry, you got to, that's right. You got to tell the devil it is written. You don't have the authority. Amen. I'm telling you, get in your word. And if that's not breaking it, then join us on this fast, because I believe that the God that we serve is able to do anything but fail. Yes, I love that violent faith. My faith is not backing down. It's not going back, not on my watch.
Jesus, glory to God, glory to God. And I was just even seeing that some of you are in the healthcare field. Some of you work in hospitals, you work in doctor's offices. And so God is going to really begin to use you to bring forth healing in those areas. And so even during that time of that watch that you're there, God wants to use you. He wants you to cause the people to be set free in the name of Jesus. You may be working yourself out of a job, amen, because there may not be any more patience for you to see or for you to take care of, because God wants to do something supernatural again. He's going to do something supernatural in your life, but he's certainly going to do some supernatural things through your life. So even God is going to begin to give you instruction. And when people, you come into contact with these people that are sick, that are downtrodden, whether it's an emotional sickness, whether it's a physical sickness, God is going to use you. God said, don't be fearful. Don't be fearful. And you don't have to go in through all of the stuff of, you know, and praying in tongues over them. You just touch them, and by the hand of God, by the power of God, they will arise, they will walk, and they will be made whole in Jesus' name. And he's going to do it suddenly. You're going to begin to see a lot more miracles manifest, amen. And so many of you, again, you have a fear, and you're like, well, God, what if it's not you? But what if it is God? It's not going to hurt you to pray for somebody. It's not going to hurt you as you speak the word. God then has a responsibility to oversee his work, to make sure that it's performed. God sends his word to us and he heals us. So if God sends the word, you can send the word as well, so that people can be healed and set free. This is what the world is looking for. They're looking for the supernatural. They're looking for things that they haven't seen before. They're tired of the same old stuff. They're tired of religion. They're tired of tradition. They want the supernatural manifestation of God, and he's going to use you as a conduit to bring it forth in the earth.
Amen. Some people are asking about fast information. I don't want to make it complicated. What we're doing is when we start the midnight cry for midnight, our time or whatever time you have until like 3 p.m. Sometimes we've been doing 6 p.m. We're just no food, no water. We've just been praying and seeking God during those times, praying, getting in our word. So again, midnight to like 3 p.m, that's kind of how we do our fast, between 3 and 6, depending on what we have going on that day, we'll break our fast. But again, that's just basically what we're doing. There are no other major information, amen. We're reading, we're studying, we're praying, we're believing God for amazing things, for the manifestation of his presence in our lives, seeking God for for God to break through, amen, for God to use us, not only for the breakthrough in our lives, but also not only for us, but for other people, amen, because we don't want to just pray selfish prayers. We don't want to pray just prayers for us, amen, and we started like 2 days ago, so it ends, I think, it's the 12th, and the 12th of May.
Yes.
Amen. So that's what we're doing, the 12th of May, 21 days, and that's all we're doing, basically 21 days, and we're just really praying, going back in again. And I think this is the third or fourth time this year we fasted, but every time we fasted, we've seen great breakthrough. We've seen people begin to break through. No, we're doing 12 o'clock midnight till 3 or till 6. It just depends on where you're at. Some people have to have medicine. They have to eat and stuff like that, so we understand that. But I'm telling you, it's time for us to come together collectively to fight, to stand together, to believe God for supernatural things, amen, and for us also not to be selfish in our prayers. We need to not only be praying for ourselves, but we need to pray for, yes, the scripture said, this kind cometh not out but by prayer and with fasting, amen?
Yes.
And so sometimes you have to fast and pray in order to see things broken over people's lives, amen? And so we're willing, amen, to come out and to pray and to fast and to seek God, amen, and to see God do amazing miracles, not only for ourselves and not only for our church and for our ministry, but also for for yours as well. Amen. And so we're praying and we're believing, God, for different leaders and different friends of ours who are pastors, for them to sustain momentum. Amen. For them to, even for you to sustain momentum. Amen. We don't want you to just, we don't want you to have broken through for the first 3 months of the year and then the fourth, fifth, and sixth month, the enemy come back and take back ground that he's taken. No, we're not doing that. Amen. Yes. We're believing God for supernatural miracles. We're believing God for supernatural power. We're believing that God will move in your life like never before. And we're also praying for you that every demonic assignment of hell that's been framed against your ministry, your marriage, your money, every part of your life,
yes,
we're believing God that God is going to break that and that he's not going to allow it. Even every weapon that's been framed against you, we declare, yes, that you'll see the weapon, but it will not prosper. Yes. And so that's our declaration over your life, over our health, over your ministry,
yes,
over our ministry. Amen. We're not just praying for us because we're not praying selfish prayers, but we're believing God for the supernatural manifestation,
Jesus,
and the supernatural and the supernatural manifestation of,
yes,
things that God would break things through. Amen. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
I need somebody to hear me because I don't want this to just to be a regular time of prayer and time of fasting. Amen. But this is a time where we're really seeing things broken. You're really seeing,
yes,
the power of God
destroy,
sweep the land, mm-hmm, destroy, amen, your neighborhood, your block, your city, that God himself is beginning to come and destroy, and he is not letting the enemy come in and cause and let things prosper. Amen. I think that sometimes things happen in our families, in our churches, in our business, in our marriages, because we are not praying. Amen.
Yes.
And we are not standing in the gap of intercession.
Yes.
And we're not doing it on a continual basis. Amen.
Yes.
And so we want God to do it. We want God to do it. And that's why we have not been able to stop this prayer, because every night we need to cry out at midnight,
Jesus,
and believe God for supernatural manifestation,
yes,
in the lives of his people. Amen. I do not want to see some. Yes, you can join the fast today. Amen.
Yes.
There are some people that are saying, my God, I don't understand this. I don't understand why I'm not getting breakthrough. And so we're going to believe God for your breakthrough. Amen. The person that says this is going on or that's going on. Amen. I'm telling you, it's time for your breakthrough. Amen. You may not have been able to do it by yourself, but we as a collective family, all of us standing together, we can believe God for the breakthrough in the lives of his people. Amen.
Yes.
And so I'm believing that for you. We're believing that for you. There are some that have been on here for the entire 90 something days that we've been praying. And so we're,
Jesus,
standing together in agreement. We're believing God for you.
Yes.
We're standing in agreement for your breakthrough, for your family, for your marriage, for your children. Amen. For your finances,
yes,
for your business. Amen.
Unity.
For your church.
Unity.
Amen.
Yes.
In unity, as we stand together, we will see the manifestation of the things that we're praying for. Amen. And I'm telling you, we're gonna go and we're gonna recover all. I'm telling you, and then not only are you gonna recover all, you're gonna come back with the spoil. Amen. You're,
yes,
coming back out of this fight with enough for you and for somebody else. Amen. God's not just gonna bless you with enough for you, he's gonna bless you with enough for everybody else. And so we're decreeing that tonight. We're declaring it tonight. And the word says, even if we decree a thing, amen, that we shall, that God will establish it. Amen.
Yes.
And so that's what we're believing. We're believing that for you.
Yes.
I'm telling you, when I fast, my faith arises. Amen. When I fast, my faith gets to a place where I can believe God for,
yes,
anything. Amen. My prayer life increases when I fast.
Gift of faith.
When
yes,
the gift of faith arises in me,
yes,
it causes everything that's doubting in me to stop.
Jesus.
Amen. And it causes,
yes,
that to be subsided. Amen.
Yes.
I once heard a man said that which dog is it that if you got a white dog and a black dog, he said, which one of them is going to be the strongest? And I would say, I don't know. I said, but he said, it's the dog that you feed the most. And so you gotta you gotta feed, amen. You gotta feed your faith, amen. You gotta feed your faith, you gotta believe in your faith, amen. You gotta believe that God, yes, that God is greater than any enemy and any assignment of hell that's been framed,
yes,
against you. You gotta believe that. Amen.
Yes.
You gotta believe it. You
Absolutely.
Gotta believe
Absolutely.
That God is able,
yes,
to do exceeding abundantly,
abundantly
above all you can ask or think. According to the
power
that's working in you, according,
yes,
to the authority that you've been given, according to,
yes,
the dunamis power, the ability to work miracles, the power,
Jesus,
is in you. You have it. God didn't just do it for Smith Wigglesworth. He didn't just do it for Paul and Peter and James and John. And Jesus said that we'll do the greater works. Amen.
Yes.
So I'm telling you, if you'll consecrate yourself, many of you still have the oil of consecration. Anoint yourself every,
yes,
day. Take communion every day. When you break,
yes,
your fast,
come on,
amen, take communion,
yes,
again.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
Get back back into your oil of consecration. Get to the place, amen, where you anoint yourself. Get your oil, amen, and anoint yourself and decree over yourself, amen, and declare over yourself. Glory I'm telling God. You, some people Glory may not understand God. It, but Jesus. Decree and declare over yourself. Jesus. Prophesy over yourself. Prophesy over your finances. Prophesy over your husband. Prophesy over your wife. Yes. Prophesy over your children. Yes. Prophesy over your church. Walk through the length and the breadth and the height and the depth of it and decree and declare and ask God for instructions. Ask him for witty inventions. Ask him to give you wisdom on how to do what you need to be able to do, because the way he did it last time may not be the way he's going to do it this time.
Right.
And so you got to ask God for that, that information on how to really tap into where he's taking you to in this season so that then you can receive the breakthrough that you're looking for. Jesus. Amen. God wants to do it for you. It's his desire to give you the kingdom. Even as he told them, it's his good pleasure to give you the kingdom.
Yes.
It's his desire to give you the kingdom. If we delight ourselves in him, he'll give us the desires of our heart. Amen.
Right.
And so God wants to do it. All his promises are yea and they are amen. So you got to stand on the authority that God has given you and believe him for mighty miracles. Amen. And I'm telling you, there is no way that when we stand together and believe God for supernatural miracles, you walk through your house, you get your oil, and you walk through your house, and you anoint every part of your house. Amen. You anoint everything that pertains to your house. You anoint everything that's around your house, everything that's not coming into alignment. Come on, pray for it. Come on, decree over it. Come on, prophesy over it. Come on, declare it. Amen. Cast devils out of your, that's right. Cast devils out of everything that's in your house that's not aligning with the purpose of God. Amen.
Jesus.
Decree, 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 declare, declare, declare. Open up your mouth and begin to confess what you believe in God for, not what you see and not what the enemy said and not what your naysayers said, not even what the people said that are not in agreement with what you believe in God for. No, you take your authority, amen, and believe God for supernatural miracles. Amen. You take your authority and believe God for supernatural miracles because it is your season.
My God,
for suddenness to happen in your life.
Yes.
That's right.
Amen.
We come against confusion
and
strife and all those kind of things that the enemy, amen, and dry bones, amen. We speak life to dry bones tonight.
Jesus.
Somebody asked, what can they buy the oil? What can they get this oil? Now, somebody said, well, you know, you can use any oil, but I know we specifically prayed over this oil. And so you can definitely get this on our website, www.lajunandvalora.com. Amen. www.lajunandvalora.com. I'm telling you, it's our desire to see you break through. Amen.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes. Amen. You've got to release your voice in this season. You've got to release your voice because the enemy has been always after your voice because he realizes there is power in decreeing and declaring. And so whatever he think he can do to try to silence your voice, that you don't feel like you have enough strength to speak or you don't know what to say. But God said it's the time in the season to release your voice, release your roar, release your cry, cry out unto God, and he will deliver you even as he's delivered others. And David said that. He said, I cried out unto the Lord and he delivered me and he helped me and he caused me to prosper in the name of Jesus. So God said, release your voice, declare it out of your mouth. I know we think about things and we process things sometimes on the inside, but God said, it's time to release it. It's time to speak it into the air. It's time to speak it into the atmosphere. You've got to decree and declare it out of your mouth in Jesus' name.
You know, something else I heard when we were talking about that is that you are not helpless and you are not hopeless.
Yes.
You are not in a situation where there is no help for you and there is no hope for you. The devil is a liar.
Amen.
You open up your mouth because God has given you the power. And when you open up your mouth to begin to decree and declare, you are not helpless and you are not hopeless. The anointing of God is there to change any situation, to turn any circumstance around. And so I'm telling you, keep anointing yourself. Keep decreeing. Keep declaring. You are not helpless to change your situation. Amen. The devil is a liar.
Yes,
he is trying to get you not to know who you are and what your inheritance is.
Yes.
I don't have a child who is helpless or hopeless. Amen. It doesn't matter what that relationship looks like. Amen. I'm telling you that you are not helpless and that you are not hopeless. Your father has made provision for you. The blood of Jesus Christ and the cross at Calvary has made provision for you. So all you got to do is get back into place. Somebody says, I fell into sin. Repent, get back into place.
Come on.
Amen. And the Bible says, was it a just man falls seven times? Amen. Yeah, a righteous man falls seven times, yet he gets back up again. And so get back up again. Amen. Get back up. Keep getting back up. Amen. And stop making the same mistake. Look forward. Pray for God to open your eyes so that you can see the areas where the enemy is keeps attacking and where you keep falling into the same thing. But you keep getting back up. Don't you dare let the enemy make you feel like you're helpless and you're hopeless, or that God doesn't love you anymore. I'm telling you, get back up and do what God has called you to do and be what God has called you to be. It's your season. You get back up. You are not helpless and you are not hopeless. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care how tough the situation is. I'm telling you, it's not over until God says it's over. I was looking tonight and we were doing some research in our Discipleship Institute about the Apostle John. And so here it is. They gave their reports and they were talking about their reports. And so the report said that John was the only one who died a natural death. And so they said they boiled him in peanut oil. And they said, well, what did you receive from that apostle? I said, what I received from that is that John was boiled in oil, but it could not kill him. They exiled him to the Isle of Patmos, but it could not kill him. Yes. You will not die until God says you'll die. You will not die until it's your time and until it's your season to die. So there's not a devil in hell. There's no oil that they can boil you in. Jesus. Not only is there no oil that they can boil you in, there is no island or no place that they can can stop the anointing and the purpose of God for your life. I'm telling you, you are not helpless and you are not hopeless, that God is with you. And if God be for you, nobody can be against you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. The fiery furnace can't stop you.
That's right.
It will not be able to silence your
voice. You won't even smell like smoke when you come out.
Come on. No evidence. There will be no evidence. Oh my God. There will be no evidence. Glory to the Lamb of God. See, that's the God that we serve. He removes the evidence. Glory to God. That there will be no trace of what you've been through. There will be no trace of any remnant of what you've had to endure and what you've been fighting against and what has been fighting against you. God said, I'm coming in to remove the residue of your trial in Jesus' name. Jesus.
Yes, I feel it.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Again, if you want the oil, many of you are asking about that. And it is amazing because God gave us this and he really put a burden on our heart. And even my husband was sharing about this. And God told us to go back to the original pattern, the biblical pattern in Exodus 30, 23 through 25, Exodus 30, where God gave Moses a pattern to create oil. And so oil of consecration. And so that's what we've been doing. We've been consecrating ourselves. And so as you will see here on the label, it has myrrh, cinnamon, cassia, calamus, and olive oil, five ingredients in this oil. And so God, one of the things that God said, I want some of the ingredients to be visible. So you see the cinnamon bark and you see the calamus, the whole calamus that is inside of here. And so God is just doing some amazing, amazing things. And yes, you can get that from LaJunMValora.com. LaJunMValora.com. Yes, it is a very sweet, amazing aroma. And we keep it with us. We, you know, just bless people and so forth, but continue to consecrate yourself as you present yourself unto God, as you seek him first. Amen. Continue to seek God first and everything else will come after you. His blessings will overtake you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Well, listen, we love you. We're getting out of here.
Yes.
We could probably pray all night because I'm really stirred tonight. I really believe God is doing something amazing in your lives. Tomorrow night, we're going to be here. Wednesday night at 7, we're going to do that special scope, as I said. And I'm going to figure out how to make sure that we lock in and get other people on there. But I'm telling you, I see God doing amazing things. I see him doing amazing things. Yeah, my wife said we can broadcast on Wednesday night through the group. So it's my suddenly seasoned group. We'll broadcast through the group on Wednesday night just to see God do amazing things for those that are connected to the group. If you're not in the group, make sure that you get in the group. I'm telling you, I see God doing amazing things. I see God turning it around. I see God changing it. Amen. I see God doing something for you that he is not, that he, listen, listen, let me tell you something. This is going to be the greatest breakthrough that you have ever seen. Amen. Jesus. Somebody said, I'm a supernatural miracle believer. Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
Amen. And so we're believing with you. Amen. Davidra, we're believing with you. Amen. Tamisha, we're believing with you. Amen. I Love Yams, we're believing with you.
Yes.
Amen. Everybody that's here, I am Felicia H. We're believing with you and believing for amazing things to happen in your life. Diana, Brenda, amen. Nanette, Karen, we're believing God for amazing things for your life. Those of you that are here, that have been faithful, that have been committed, amen. You're sold out to God. I'm telling you, I believe God is going to do amazing things for you. Amen. Janelle, you're going to see it. You're going to see it. I'm telling you, you're going to see God do some amazing things. Christian, amen. Christine and Yvette, amen. God is going to do things for you, and it's going to blow your mind what God is going to. Evelyn, he's going to do it. Amen. God's going to do it. Things that have been held up for years, Dominique, he's going to do it. Amen. I'm telling you, D. Williams, things that have been held up for years are getting ready to be released. Anne Marie, it's coming. Amen. Kelly Favor, it's coming. You just watch and see, won't God do amazing things in your life. Jenny, it's coming for you. Amen. The God of the suddenlies is coming to your house. Grateful John, he's coming to your house. The God of the suddenlies is coming to your house. You're going to see the manifestation of the things that you've been praying for, things that you've been believing for. God is going to do it. It's going to happen. Breakthrough is your portion. Michelle Strong Swift, breakthrough is coming. I'm telling you, many of you have been waiting and you've been waiting and you've been waiting. I'm telling you, it's coming. Amen. Stand on it. Believe for it. Trust God for it, because it's coming. You watch this scope afterwards. I'm telling you, it's coming to you too. Amen.
Yes.
So God knows how to cause it to find you and locate you. We've been seeing people get checks in the mail from places that have been held up 5 and 10 years ago. Moses is coming to your house, sir.
Yes.
Cecilia, it's coming to your house. Amen. You believe God for it. Victoria, I see it coming to your house. I'm telling you that it's coming to your house. And so we bless you. I am. Haley's was coming to your house. Amen.
Yes.
Stand on it. Believe God for it. Know that God is not going to fail. Joanna, it's coming. Amen.
Jesus.
So listen, we love you. I'm getting out of here. Promotion, it's coming. Amen.
Yes.
I'm telling you, it's coming to your house.
And it's going to spill over to other people's lives. As God releases your suddenly, it's going to spill over into other people's lives. It's going to bless other people. It's going to bless your family. It's going to bless your community. It's going to bless people that are connected to you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So, well, we love you guys.
So you guys, hey, listen, if you, again, I want to ask, if you did not share, make sure you share. Because I believe that this scope is going to bless some people. I believe it's going to minister to some people.
Yes.
And I believe that people's lives are going to be impacted.
Cause I'm fighting.
Cause God said, I'm fighting for you.
I'm fighting for you.
Jesus.
Is there any more that needs to bow a knee? Come right now.
Yes.
Come on, stand with us. Come on, stand with us and decree with us.
Surrender. You won't lose, cause I'm fighting. I'm fighting. I'm fighting for you. All you have to do is surrender. You won't lose, cause the Lord is fighting.
Yeah.
He's fighting.
Yeah. Fighting.
Mm. That thing starts circling.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
But the Lord is fighting.
Yes.
Fighting for you. So just lift
the
up.
Psalmist praying, I surrender. Diana, he's fighting for you. Daphne, submit. He's fighting for you. My daddy's girl is fighting for you.
He's fighting.
Ben-Gur, he's fighting for you, sir. Diane DeHaan, he's fighting for you. Cher Campbell, he's fighting.
Yes.
I surrender.
But we love you guys. We are getting out of here.
Yes.
And we will see you on tomorrow. We pray blessings and favor increase upon your lives like never before. Let these be the greatest breakthroughs of your life.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.